What's going on, everybody? It's Eric Ray with the back here helping you take your game to the next level. And in today's video, I'm going to be showing you an absolutely glitchy passing play that beats all defenses in Madden 18. Now, if this is your first time checking out one of my videos, go ahead and hit the subscribe button below. Make sure to hit the bell icon so that you join the notification squad and never miss an upload. So today I want to show you guys a very powerful play. It's kind of a gimmicky play, but it works very good at attacking how people are playing defense right now, and it's a real pain to stop. It's only in the Steelers playbook, however, but the Steelers do have one of the better playbooks in the game, and of course if you use a custom playbook, you can use this as well. So the play we want to look at is the fake screen sluggo out of gun empty Steeler. Now you can't make any hot routes on this play because this is technically like a screen play, so they won't let you make hot routes on it. I didn't mean to hike the ball there, so I'm just going to throw it away. What's really good about this play is no matter how the defense decides to play us, we're going to have ways that we can absolutely destroy them. So first we're going to look at the cover 4 hard flat look that you're going to see a lot this year, or have been seeing a lot this year. It's one of the more popular ways to play defense. What's so great about this is we have two routes on this field. If they play this, you know, style of defense, we have two routes on this field that they have to either manually guard or they have to like really adjust to stop. And even if they do that, we have a third option we can hit them with. So first off, if they're playing the hard flat cover 4 look, first thing we have is Antonio Brown on this wheel route. Right when he cuts past this linebacker, we pass lead it to the sideline, we hold possession, catch, bam. That's an easy big gain right there. So that's the first thing we have. Secondly, okay, let's say they go user that. Then what's going to happen here is we have Jesse James, the wide receiver here, or tight end, cutting across this side of the field. Bam, that's an even bigger gain. Cannot defend this with the cover 4 hard flat look. Now, let's say somehow they adjusted, they did something to take away one route. And keep in mind, like the crossing route is going to be the hardest one to take away because purple zones, nothing's going to really get deep down there to defend that. So that's the one they really have to use her. Maybe they put like a purple zone or they add a cloud flat to the side of the field where Brown is to take away his wheel route. But then this is what happens. So let's say you're letting the play develop and nothing's open. They're covering both routes. Then what you want to do is you want to playmaker Le'Veon Bell up and then pass it to him. Now that was a bad pass by Ben, but you saw that he was wide open. The playmaker feature comes in really handy on this play, and that's what makes it tough to stop. The playmaker, all you got to do is hold the right stick in the direction you want Le'Veon Bell to go. So we want him to go up, so we just hold it up, and right when he clears everybody, we're getting huge gains with him, and then we're in the open field trying to make moves. So those three things right there, it just makes it almost impossible for them to attack. So now let's say they did cover 4, but they did cloud flats because they're trying to take away the wheel route and such. So if they do this, the wheel route will be taken away because that linebacker is going to drop back with the wheel route. But even with cloud flats on the field, that's not going to take away this crossing route because the cloud flat does not get deep enough back there. So no matter if they're playing underneath or over top, we're going to still have that crossing route every single time. So that is, like I said, you have to manually guard that. But here's what's even better. If they don't play hard flats, it's so much easier to hit Le'Veon Bell because everybody's just dropping back immediately. So we just playmaker him up and we pass it immediately. And you see the huge gain we get because since the defense is not playing underneath, they're just going to keep dropping back. So that right there is just an absolute pain to defend. We have two routes that pretty much one has to be manually guarded. One has to be adjusted to stop. And then on top of that, we have a playmaker that we can hit. And we don't have to always lead him up the field too. We could lead him across the middle of the field. Just depending on the look that we're getting, but I tend to like to pass lead him up, but we'll show here in this example that we can actually playmaker him over the middle of the field if we want as well. But it's just not going to pick up as many yards. See, there we didn't lead him up enough. We let him like right into the offensive line. But you're not going to get as many yards out of that, but it just depends. If they're like using that side of the field or something because they expect you to playmaker him up, then you want to like playmaker him like more like this, and then you see we're still picking up about 10 yards with it. So that's the creative thing with playmaking is once you playmaker him up the field a few times, they may try to use that to take it away, but then you can just playmaker him over the middle of the field. But the thing is, if they start guarding your playmaker, then again your A route to Jesse James is going to be open because that has to be manually guarded. So here we'll go cover 3 hard flats. I just want to show it against some other coverages. Now keep in mind, if you're going against someone that's like blitzing very heavy, then this won't be the best play for you. This is better against people that play more coverage style defenses, but you're going to see more coverage style defenses this year than blitzes. I mean, you're going to see some blitzes. It really depends on your opponent, but you're seeing a lot of cover four, cover two, just, you know, 7-8 men in coverage. So that's why this is going to be such a tough play to defend for people that play that way. If you're playing a heavy blitzer, then I don't really recommend going to this too much, because obviously this takes a little bit of time to develop. But you can see against various coverages, we have pretty much two routes that have to be keyed in on, and we have the playmaker that's so easy to maneuver him around the field. So definitely try to get this in your arsenal if you can. If you're in the Pittsburgh Steelers playbook, definitely use this play. It's a pain to stop. It is gimmicky, but it's definitely something that's going to give your opponent headaches. Not something I would abuse, something I would throw in there, like in those situations where you really need to pick up some tough yards. It's going to be very hard for them to stop this play. They're going to need to see this play run about 4, 5, 6 times before they even catch on to really what's going on for most players. So that's what makes it really tough, is like by the time they catch on, it might just be too late in the game for them. So definitely add this to your arsenal, see what it can do for you. If you guys enjoyed this video, as always, you know the drill. Just drop a like, comment, subscribe, and I will see you guys next time.